So in this video, I'm going to show the glass blowing routines of making the Farnsworth fusor as a sealed tube. So here are the components, the grid, the tube, and the anode, which I made from the metal mesh. The grid and anode are stainless steel with the tungsten leg. So the first thing is to make a glass bead on the tungsten leg so that I can connect the grid to the outer tube of the fusor. First we need to heat the tungsten, then to press the glass so it sticks, and to heat it once more to make it even. Now I use the thermal resistant wool to cover the grid and push it into the tube until it fits.
Okay.
Things here are quite simple. I just weld it and it welds. So after removing the wool, we can see that it is perfectly centered and the electrode feed through looks well. Well, that looks pretty good, even, and probably it would survive. Now to the next part. I need to insert the metal mesh anode into the tube, then weld the tungsten bead electrode to the side of the tube and close the open end. And voila, that's it. So let's go. First of all, some preheat so that the glass doesn't crack. Now welding the anode tungsten bead to the tube. My previous two attempts of this operation have failed, and therefore this time I'm much more careful than usually. Okay, now that's done, I'm heating the tube so the heat is evenly distributed among the glass surface to reduce the tensions. And the fun part is using maximum power of my GTT delta leap torch to close the open end of the tube. Out a diameter of 90 millimeters, thickness about 1.5 millimeters, 2 millimeters. That's quite a lot. So I heat it with maximum power, then use graphite tools to narrow the opening and the glass rods to close it and to remove the excessive glass. I'm constantly blowing into the tube to make the heated glass distribute among the closed end. Well, that was the first one, and now the second one. Practically two attempts are enough to make it even. Now I just heat it, heat and blow, heat and blow, heat and blow, until it becomes more or less rounded. And that's it. Now I heat the whole tube to pre-anneal it to distribute the internal tensions of the glass while the kiln is heating up. Checking the temp. Temp is around 600-700 degrees Celsius. Some more. And voila, it is ready. Goes to the tube. See you next time.